Hello, Ms. Conroy. Iris Esquivel here, just putting on my CAM recorder to get ready for this lesson. So I'm going to be putting, right now I'm putting the recorder on, even though they're still at recess. I just don't want to interrupt the flow by having to go in the back of the class to put the recorder on. So you're going to be seeing basically everything from recess until lunch, but then of course in my email to you, I will tell you what time marker to skip to so you can go and see the direct lesson right away instead of looking through all this nonsense. Okay, so I can't wait to hear your comments and feedback on my lesson, and I wish you a great day. Enjoy!
You know what? You totally can. I want to do recess today.
Here. I'm pretty sure this would be the center classroom. So they're in order. Okay?
I'll just go see if one of my
dogs yet. Let's think.
Daniela says.
Daddy's here, yeah?
No, Daddy's here.
Are you?
Yeah, Oscar's there. Robert
is Daddy's here.
Yes. Daniela, that's in.
You see, verifica.
Again.
I have no numbers. You got me.
And Cindy, I know what Cindy says.
Yeah. I don't really see
Andrea today. Roberts.
Roberts is right there. But, oh no. Next to Ashley, yeah. Yeah. Henry.
Hector.
Is here. Isaiah. Alex, who I always call Anthony.
John.
Luis, Kev,
Glenn,
Seth, Ryan, Christopher,
Jalen, where's Jalen?
Jalen's right there. Why is he the only one with a name sticker? He's the only one
with a name sticker right there.
Huh?
And you look at not have a message.
Check in her internet.
What number is she? Because I know that she's a
at feel some of them are new, and I want to make sure we're respecting them all. The five-finger countdown, when I get to zero, Henry, and I see someone talking, what do? I want to make sure, I know you know when, I want to make sure Henry, because he was so close to facing the consequences. If the best people goes in the air, five, four, three, zero, I should hear them talking, right? Well, what am I going to do if I hear someone disrespecting that? Get a mark right away, or is Mrs. Still a little bit? Give you a warning.
Oh, I
know,
I
know. You're good. You need to get the person warning. I give you a warning, so I write your name on the board, okay? And if I have to address you again, then I'm going to give you a mark. No fuss, no foul. It just goes into a mark, okay?
Okay.
So, boys and girls, you all have your English copybooks at your desk. You will see at somewhere, usually probably the last page or second last page, I've given you a mark 3, 2, or 1. So, these are your marks. Today we're going to be continuing our rough drafts, and we're going to be starting our peer review. Now, I know that together we've done kind of informally some peer reviews. Apart from the one you did with me, raise your hand if you have ever received a rubric and you have actually officially given a grade to a peer. Do you see them at the table? Yeah? Okay. Do we know what a rubric is, boys and girls?
No.
Yeah? Any ideas? Hands up? Tell me what a rubric is? Anthony?
Rubik's?
No, Rubik's is a shape, but something different. Ashley? Not quite ideas. It's a bit more serious than that. Many people are afraid of Rubik's. I don't want you to be.
A rubric is basically a system of steps so it'll teach you how to grade a specific assignment.
When Ms. Burchard and when Ms. Esquivel grades your things, we don't just throw it a number. We're not like, B plus. No, we have a system of things that we follow, and following these things, it shows us how we're going to grade you. So I'm going to pass these out now. When you are done your rough draft, here's what's going to happen. Here's how we're going to choose partners. Quietly, you're going to raise your hand. And it's going to go in couples. So the first two people I see with their hands up, they're going to switch. And let's just say a third person raises their hand. Up, missing a partner, then the fourth person will switch, okay? So basically, whenever you interrupt, Jeff, raise your hand and we'll find you a partner in the class. That way we can stop doing the whole, like, oh, it's elbow buddies. So we do that a lot. I want you guys to switch the rubric, okay? So I'm going to hand these out to you, and we're going to go over the rubric first together. Matt, can you get the set of questions, please?
No.
So,
need my elbow buddy. It's
you three.
There's enough of them.
Matthew.
You know that you have to get tucker, right? Name of student whose work I am correcting. Okay? Right away, I want you all to take out a red pen if you have. Or any kind of pen, because we're going to be doing our rough draft hopefully in pencil. So when you are correcting your friend's work, it will be very clear if you're correcting in pencil. So choose a different color pencil or a different color pen. A blue pen is okay. What question was, can I use highlighter? Okay, so we're going to start off. We're going to start off by writing our names on the first line. Let's see which group can get that done first. Okay, I need a simple task. Everyone should have their name written on their first line. Raise your hand in your group if you're already done.
Raise your hand.
Okay, good. So we've all done the first step. Hands down. Thank you. I just wanted to get an idea of who's following. Okay, now ideally, because the three is the best mark you can give your buddy, we want to read the instructions for all the best case scenarios. So we have one, two, three, four, five different things we're going to be correcting. Commas, capitals, punctuation, quotation marks, and spelling. Spelling is always important, but like Isabel mentioned, for this particular piece, what I'm looking at the most will be your commas and your quotation marks, okay? But the other things are important. So, if your buddy gets like the best possible, you will circle, okay? You will circle the category that you think they belong to. So let's just say I'm correcting Cindy's short story, and I see that her capitals are just, they're perfect. All sentences begin with a capital, including the beginning of dialogue. So quotation marks. I'm gonna circle that box for Cindy. You don't have to do the text, you have it correctly, okay? And so I will circle a box in each category for my partner. Can we go through now? What would be a three for every category? Walter, can you read my ideal situation for comma, please?
I want to talk it, but I don't know. Can I read it? Oh, my short story?
Hello. You got to just, we're on our rubrics now. And you're reading, let's just say you're correcting my short story. And now you're looking, you want to grade how I use my commas. So the best case scenario would be a three for me. What do I have to do to get a three, Walter?
Commas, demonstrate this, mark, pauses, and city, state, country, state, and
Ryan, what do you think I should give my partner if they got some commas right, but also like they're missing a lot of commas?
Two!
A two, right?
Yeah.
Can you please read the description for a two?
Most commas are grammars. Grammatically correct or present, but some are missing or incorrect.
Okay, that seems like a good midpoint. And actually, what about if your partner just really dropped the ball? What do you think of them if they're really just missing a lot of them? And what if you lose really, So we're not going to read all of the three to ones for all of them. I just want to read the threes. I already read the capitals. Punctuation, Henry, for a three. What do I need to do if I want three? Perfect. Quotation marks, Isabella. quotation marks. It has to be a word-to-word thing. Okay? And last one, spelling? Matthew?
Spelling is very strong.
Okay, excellent. Okay. So, I'm going to be giving you around 15, maybe 20 minutes to finish doing your rough draft. A reminder for those who are doing rough drafts, what are the questions, there are five of them, that help us create a good story? Genevieve. Who? What? When?
Where?
Where?
Why?
What? Wait, who and where? Why? Okay. Yeah. The ones that are especially helpful for your stories are going to be the who. So,
when? Why?
Characters.
Who?
It's amazing when I was going around how amazing some of your characters are. Just like the faster you think about them, sometimes the better they are. Who do I want to write about? A polar bear. His name is?
Calm.
How old is he, Alex?
4.
All of a sudden, I have an amazing character. I have a 19-year-old polar bear named Tom. I can keep going with my characters until I have enough that I'm like, yeah, I can write a story about them. Okay? Another one. When. A very important one. Who can help me quietly raise your hand? Who's going to think a when? For my 19-year-old Paul Colbert named Tom. Alex?
2019,
perfect.
Yay, Kanye!
And the last one that's very important is going to be the where. Ezra, can you help me figure out a location? Perfect. There are two more things that are very important for you to identify when writing a story. And they're important for every story. Can you hear that? Alex? That's true. This is part of like the five W's. But something else. Every story has something that goes wrong. Jalen? Problem and solution. Okay? So, when I count down my fingers, I want you all to go into your rough drafts. Make sure to have these things. A good problem, a good solution, some good characters, a location, and when it's happening. Okay? If you have questions, throughout, raise your hands. I will come see you individually. And when you are done your rough draft and you feel like you're ready to go into your peer editing, raise your hand again and I will find you a partner for that. Are there any questions for the class so far? Andrea? Do you have to write this? Technically, we already wrote this in our brainstorm. This is just this is just a review to get your mind thinking. You already have it on your notes. Address? Could we? What do we think? Can we put a fake address?
Yeah.
Totally. Okay. My fingers go down, we start the task, you got 50 minutes on the clock, okay?
Oh, how?
Begin, please.
No.
One page long, not skipping lines. One page long, not upside down.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm Thank you. I don't know what it is.
I know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
one. That's group two. Kevin, where's your stuff?
New
page.
Like the
no way that half of the class is completely done hanging out and the other class is still writing. You guys can write basically the same speed. So write right away.
Okay.
Give you about 10 more seconds.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Next slide.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. This one is very important. How to summarize. And actually, Luis basically said this in his own words earlier. You read the text. Because you can't think that you can read one sentence and be like, oh, yeah, I know what the story is about. You have to really read the entire thing, take a second, let it sink in, and decide, okay, how am I going to summarize it? What does this text really mean? Sometimes the best way we summarize is when a long time has passed. So if I read you a story today, and I asked you in a month from now, guys, remember that story I read you? What was it about? I'm sure, without even trying, you guys would create beautiful summaries in just like a sentence, because you would have forgotten all the unimportant details, and all you'd be left with was the important point of the story that you guys read you. So you read the text. Ask, what is this text really about? I put number 2 there, don't let the word scare you, because sometimes when I'm reading even, I'll come across a word I don't understand, and I really fixate on it. And I focus on that word, like, oh, I won't be able to understand the story if I can't understand every word. It's not always the point. Especially with the summary, those big words are not always so important, because they don't really detract from the main point of the story. And like Louis was saying also, your answer should be a complete sentence or two. Sometimes, if you're reading a very long text, and there's a lot of important information, like dates, you know, or cities, like where it was, or character names, if those details are very important, it's okay if you have a third sentence, so long as it is incredibly important information that you feel you must include. Ryan, I want you here, please. about you too here. Please come back.
Summary.
Ryan?
The summary is good.
Like,
tell me.
It's
like they ask what's the summary.
Okay, so basically, you can create a summary by adding more things, but mostly you just need key points and main ideas.
Exactly. Well, this email is going to give you an example, and I want to see who can create a summary for this next little thing. Actually, this is a whiteboard for us. Louise, can you get the whiteboard trick for me?
Yeah.
Oh.
Wow.
He's
right.
He
said the
F word.
Does
anyone miss me?
Do you write the writing on your thing? Or what are you writing your whiteboard? And how do you win? The person who can convey the main point while using as huge as possible will win the round. Okay. I don't want to hear everyone's voice. Okay, this can be done quietly and it can be fun. Okay, so the first rhyme.
Five words?
Okay. I want to hear Johnny's.
Two.
Okay. spider fell. A spider. Wait, love it.
Spider
fell on a fence. Good summary. Want to redo it then?
Spider tries to climb a water fountain.
Very good. Okay, we'll do one more.
This is Alexia
in Paris.
I'm Eden in Paris.
Bye.
And you are going to find titles for the following pictures by extracting their main meaning. By extracting their main meaning. Okay? So there's four pictures. What? What's going on? Get playing. Okay? So you're going to find titles for these four pictures by extracting what you see, the main meaning. Okay? As a group, if you are to finish this, you will share one copy of the short story and you will summarize it. Okay, you can write the answer on the paper. Summarize it all together in one or two sentences, if necessary, between one or two. Okay? I want to hand up. Please explain to me what we're doing for the first activity. Matt? Okay, perfect. And what am I going to do for this story here? Cindy? I don't know if we'll have time to get to this, so I'll start by handing out this. If you finish, I'll give you this.
Hey, Miss. Did
you get it though?
It's working. Splendid.
Thank you.
body parts. She needed a helping.
What is the plumber at Wanda? Catch monkey pair
at Wanda.
Yeah.